something that we don't know about them yet and kind of make the adjust to the game as it goes on. I think we did a pretty good job of that. Keep up balance, keep looking for B inside, you know, keep making shots when we have them and make the right decisions with basketball. And of course, early on in the season, the turnovers usually hard one way or another. So play the tempo the way we need to play and hopefully make it to where, you know, I'll take a similar to what I saw Tuesday. If you can get that, we'll certainly take that again. This is a good challenge for us again. A sectional final series, you have a chance to see where you stand heading into February, but this early in November. So the basic things that we've done well in this program always will help us, and of course the finals will be the top of that. So keep fingers crossed, and hopefully we can stay healthy too.
Five starters. Well, no surprise. It's that iron five from the other night. All five of them got over 30 minutes. So we're going to go with our two seniors, B. Pollock and Carly Murphy, and then sophomores, Alexa Howell and Becky Malco, and keep safe here.
Stay, thanks for your time. Good luck. We'll talk to you after the game.
Thanks. Looking forward to it.
Lady Zebra head coach Tony Stasiak back with more pregame after this on 92.1 WROI.
Statistics show that 99% of all farms are family owned. If you're a farmer, you want to make certain that you carry on the family tradition by passing it down to the next generation. Make certain that you protect your heritage by talking to your Pekin Insurance Agency, Jennings Insurance in Rochester and Argus. They'll help you create an estate plan for your farm that will treat all heirs equally, even those who don't farm, and have sufficient funds for income, gifts, and estate taxes. You can do all this and more with the right insurance plan from Jennings Insurance, representing Pekin Insurance. Call 574-224-7777 in Rochester and 574-892-5249 in Argus today about carrying on the family legacy for years to come.
Products are the purest way to get your daily requirement. When shopping, load up on the perfect foods. Dairy products from Dean Foods, Rochester. Dean Foods, created by nature, delivered by Dean.
Coca-Cola Bottling Company of Plymouth wants you to enjoy your world. And now the basketball, swimming, and wrestling are back. And college and pro football continue. There's plenty to do. So whether it's heading for the gym, holiday open houses, and getting together with friends and family, grab the refreshingly clean taste of Coca-Cola, Diet Coke, Coke Zero, Sprite, and Sprite Zero. Make sure you have plenty of Coca-Cola products on hand, either from the store or the vending machine. Coca-Cola products go great with everything you do. It's the real thing. It's Coca-Cola.
Telephone is your lifeline. Lifeline is a federal benefit that makes monthly telephone service more affordable for eligible low-income households. A subscriber that meets criteria as established by the Indiana Utility Regulatory Commission and lives within the Rochester Telephone Company service area must be a participant in one of the following programs to qualify for the Lifeline benefit: Medicaid, food stamps, supplementary security income, federal public housing assistance, low-income home energy program, temporary assistance to needy families, national school lunch free program, and income-based federal eligibility. Only one lifeline benefit per household is allowed. For more information or to see if you qualify for lifeline assistance, please call Rochester Telephone Company at 223-2-2-3-2-3-2-3-2-3-2-3-2-3-2-3-2-3-2-3-2-3-2-3-2-3-2-3-2-3-2-3-2-3-2-3-2-3-2-3-2-3-2-3-2-3-2-3-2-3-2-3-2-3-2-3-2-3-2-3-2-3-2-3-2-3-2-3-2-3-2-3-2-3-2-3-2-3-2-3-2-3-2-3-2-3-2-3-2-3-2-3-2-3-2-3-2-3-2-3-2-3-2-3-2-3-2-3-2-3-2-3-2-3-2-3-2-3-2-3-2-3-2-3-2-3-2-3-2-3-2-3-2-3-2-3-2-3-2-3-2-3-2-3-2-3-2-3-2-3-2-3-2-3-2-3-2-3-2-3-2-3-2-3-2-3-2-3-2-3-2-3-2-3-2-3-2-3-2-3-2-3-2-3-2-3-2-3-2-3-2-3-
of Detroit megabytes per second. For homeowners with fewer options for internet service or who live in rural areas, there's nothing in an option that exceeds broadband. Sure, service is incredibly fast. Enjoy better video channels, less jitters, and then receive files quickly. Exceptionally fast when browsing an email, listen to streaming music. If you're ready for a faster internet connection, you're ready for exceeded broadband. Call 574-223-3156 today to learn about the amazingly fast exceed broadband service offered by your local Fulton County REMC.
Guard number 4, a 5'4" droppable number 20, Becky. Chiefs Power Pro. Choose from and that forward, a 5 foot cannon, feature number 23, Premier Power. Like a new
1702
Main Street in Rochester, or at MikeAnderson.com. Remember, we've
got great
if you're stuck with high monthly car payments and think it's the best you can do, think again. By refinancing your car loan with State Farm Bank, you may save on your monthly payments and have more money to spend on other things. Call State Farm agent Jeff Klinkhammer at 223-3017 for more information. Jeff will help you see how much you could save by refinancing with State Farm Bank. That's Jeff Klinkhammer at 223-3017. State Farm Bank, member FDIC, equal housing lender.
Back at Rochester High School, time now for the start of this basketball game. The Culver Academy Lady Eagles takes the tip, and Rochester starts in that 1-3-1 zone, which just created a turnover as Keaton Stasiak picks up a loose basketball and runs to our left. Brad Thomas on David Musselman. We'll get to the starters here momentarily. Keaton Stasiak in the baseline. Turnaround jump in the paint is no good. A lot of contact. Then the rebound fought for, and Culver comes out of there with it. Quickly up the floor is Stiers. Stiers, middle of the floor, swings outside to Weinberg. Weinberg behind the arc. Rochester in that 1-3-1 zone. Back to Stiers on the right wing behind the three-point line. Over the top of the defense to Holzer. Holzer in the corner to Weinberg. She'll fire a three from long range. No good. Gets the roll. Rebound. The putback is good. Carter Becky Malko, right side of the floor, across the timeline. Now hesitates, gives back middle of the floor to Murph. And Murphy bounces it off the foot of Victoria Chrislieb, one of the two seniors on the floor tonight for the Culver Academy Eagles.
6 foot guard.
Yeah, yeah. Five guards, in fact.
Yeah, well, we've got nine guards on the floor tonight.
Murph looks to get it in around Chrislieb. Does in the backcourt near the Academy free throw line. And Alexa Holland walks it through the center circle, works high on the right side to Malko. Malko holds him. Looks at the defense. 2-3 zone by the Academy Eagles. Stasiak, baseball pass over the defense, right into Brad Thomas's hands, out of bounds, and go back to the Academy.
No.
2-0, Culver. And Weinberg in the right corner for the Lady Eagles. Dribbles to the wing. Just inside the arc, the pass down little Chrislieb is taken away by B. Pollock, and she gives to Murphy, and Rochester runs down by two. Murph now on the right side of the floor. Cries up the court. Picks up her dribble as Steiner is in her grill. And Chrislieb just about to take the pocket of Malko, who feeds down little Stasiak. Ball loose, ball four. We're going to have a tie-up, and Rochester takes possession. First game of the year for the Lady Eagles. They are all over it.
They're not showing any rust. And Weinberg, she's, as a sophomore, she's pretty active on the floor.
Yeah.
Saw that on the missed shot earlier. She got her own rebound, put it back in, and now in the defensive end of the floor.
And a pass is thrown by Chrislieb, who has it stolen back by Alexa Holland. Holland bounce pass down low. Stasiak off the window. No good off the mark. And Victoria Chrislieb with the rebound. She clears and runs. Pushes ahead to Holzer. Holzer. Cross court. To Steiner, her
15-foot
jumper goes.
Culver Academy
basket,
number 20, Malik
Steiner. Full-court press by the Academy. And on the reach end is Tori Stiers. She'll pick up the foul.
Culver, number 24, Tori.
Early in the second quarter, the Winnemac Warriors lead Pioneer 14-0 in the Class 1A Regional. That's football. Full court press. Becky Malko's fouled again to the backcourt, and that's exactly what Rochester and Coach Stasiak did in game number one here tonight. They got the only foul trouble.
Chrislieb's first foul. Team second.
Full court press again by the Academy. Bounce pass into X. In the corner, she tries to first move out the defense. It's picked off and taken to the basket. And we're going to Stiers.
Carly Murphy picking up the charge. That's Stiers' second foul.
You're 5'3". You cannot throw it over 6 foot.
Right.
Murphy will look to get it in or ground to Chrislieb. Bounce pass in the corner to Malko. Back to Murphy. Murphy runs it up the floor. Go look past down low to B. Window is good. And Rochester. 4-2. And B
Pollock has a 4 points per game.
Nice work. There's Murphy to Pollock. So Culver with the basketball going to all right, Culver Academy. Ball's loose, stolen by Holland. Heck, Holland, left side of the floor. Now goes the basket. She's opens up a shot. No good. Victoria Chris Lee with the rebound. She's in the middle of the floor for Lady Eagles. Lob pass down low. It's knocked away and picked up by Rochester. Stasiak the other way. Going to our left now. 4-2. Academy. X on the baseline. 15-footer. Good. 5-4. And now another player. The Academy Lady Eagles running the other way. Steiner with the basketball for Culver. Gives him the corner to Weinberg. Feeds down low to Chris Reed. Chris Reed against the double team. Back to Weinberg in the paint. Kicks it outside to Stiers. Stiers cut off on the dribble. Malco then steals the pass and is fouled going the other way. Coming into the game for the first time in the first freshman for the Culver Academy Lady Eagles. Inbound pass goes to X. Holland, left side of the floor, being ridden all the way down the floor. Lob pass to B. Pollock on the left baseline, now outside to Malco. Malco stands behind the arc, now penetrates, kicks it out to X. X against Chris Lieb. Down top of the key, back down, restart. Bounce pass this side to Malco. Back to X, has the ball loose. And then picked up by Holland on the high on the right side. Holland around the defense. Goes to baseline. Lob pass to B. Pollock. Pollock is blocked from behind. Picked up by the Academy. Chrisley baseball pass down the floor to Steiner. Steiner then loses it through her hands. And last touch by Rochester out of bounds. It will stay with the Lady Eagles. Baseline right.
Chrisley on the defensive end of the floor for the Eagles, playing defense on the point on Holland. When the pass went low to B. Pollock, she was right there behind Pollock to swat it away.
She's quick, isn't she?
She is.
4-4, 4:23 to play in the first quarter. The Academy the basketball. Steiner pull up 15 foot on the right baseline, goes, and Carver back up. Academy Lady Eagles over the top of the defense, goes Texas pass to Malco, that is. Becky Malco between her legs, dribble, bounce pass on the near side to X. She'll fire a three left wing. It's good. Rochester.
With the Eagle Lady Eagles packing that paint.
Quickly up the floor is Weinberg. Now on the right baseline to Etheridge. Etheridge down the little Weinberg. Her shot's partially blocked by Pollock. Out of bounds. It will stay with the Academy Lady Eagles. Baseline right. Brad Thomas, I'm David Musselman. Second game of the year here for the Rochester Lady Zebras, who are 1-0. And Stiers looks to trigger it in. Gets it in the corner to Steiner. Back to Stiers on the right block. Out to Weinberg. Jumper from the elbow extended is no good. Murph grabs the board. Murphy behind her back dribble has Chris Leaf in her pocket, and half her pass is stolen by the Academy. And the wraparound pass is kicked out of bounds by Murphy. And that's another turnover on the Rochester Lady Zebras. With 3:36 to play in the first quarter, Rochester up 7-6.
That was their fourth turnover so far.
Holzer looks to get it in. Does so to Weinberg on the right baseline, or right block. Down low to Chris Lee. Baby hook in the lane goes. Holland dribbles, tries to dribble through the double team, loses the basketball. Chris Lieb reverses the layup, goes in. And now Culver back down the left side of the floor, dribbles to the wing, and she is going to be fouled on the hip by Steiner, and that's going to be out of bounds to Rochester at 3:14 to play. Down by three.
Team fifth.
Murphy will trigger it in right in front of the Academy bench. And gets it into Stasiak. Beats down the block. Outside of Malco. Malco goes to the glass. Her shot up is good. 10-9. The Academy. And quickly up the floor is Weinberg high on the right side. Baseline to Etheridge. Back to Weinberg on the right wing. At the free throw line.
The Lady Eagles move that basketball quick.
They do. You're right.
Nobody holds it for more than about 2 seconds.
Etheridge drives the baseline, pull up 8-footer. He's off the side of the backboard, no good. Murphy with the board and dribbles out of trouble. Boy, she got hands all over her. Now quickly up the floor. Left side of the floor, high on the left side. Bounce pass through the legs of Chris Lee, picked up by Stasiak Malco, and out to X for three. No good off the mark. Stasiak with the rebound. Keaton on the floor. Ball still on the floor. We're going to have a tie-up, and it's going to go back to Culver. That's going to be a foul or travel, you think.
Right, I would have thought so, too.
2:27 to play, first quarter. The Academy up 10-9, and they've got the basketball back after the tie-up. Chris Leap gets it in to Steiner, who brings it up the floor across the timeline to Weinberg. Weinberg high on the right side for the Lady Eagles, who lead 10-9. Looks in the paint. Good defense by Rochester. Out to Chris Lee. Long three for the senior. Off the mark. Way off the mark. No good. Becky Malker grabs the board, and Weinberg comes in over her back. Weinberg picks up her
second.
Gary Chris Lee did not like that shot selection.
No, I can understand that.
And I'm guessing that Margaret McKinnis will be coming in for
the full-court
pass from, I think, Murphy.
Puts the Zebras back up 11-10. Steiner LePain, her pull-up jumper goes. Murphy brings the ball off the floor, gets the man-to-man press, leads ahead to Malco. Becky back to Murphy, left side to X, thinks it's about a three, works right side. Murphy will fire a three on the way. Well, she, that's where she made her money on Tuesday night. From right there.
She just doesn't look like an outside shooter. You leave her open, she'll hurt you.
14-12 Rochester, 90 seconds to play, first quarter. Calder holds above her head against the man-to-man defense. That works to the right side. Actually, Rochester in a 1-3-1 zone. Etheridge kicks it out to Steiner for three. No good. And the rebound comes to Weinberg. Back outside to Halzer. She'll fire a three, top of the key. Nope. And X with the board. Holland now gives to Malco. Becky will bring it up the floor against the half-court trap. Against the timeline, gives to Murphy. Now ahead to Holland. 1 minute to play, first quarter. Rochester up by two. And Coach Stasiak wants to burn some clock here with 55 seconds to play, first quarter. Malco gives in the corner to Murphy. Murphy with 50 seconds loses the basketball. Back to Malco with 49. Holland now high on the right side. Back to Malco, middle of four with 45. Holland holds. Now back to Malco in the circle. Back to Holland with 40. Holland bounce pass to B. Pollock at the free throw line. Back to Malco with 37. Becky Malco, couple of dribbles. Back to Holland, high on the right side with 33. Rochester leads 14-12. And the Academy just picked up their seventh foul of the half. And that's going to send Rochester to the free throw line for the last 3 seconds.
Academy
first quarter.
That's Everett's
first foul. Team 7.
In the game for the first time is number 10, the 5'6 sophomore. And coming out of the game,
second time this week we've seen the Rochester Lady Zebras attack their opponents and get into the
7-0. Well, yeah, situation. Wow. Holland's first one. Nope. Rebound by Stasiak. The putback. No good. Partially blocked. Carver picks up the loose ball. Now ahead to Etheridge. Outside left to Steiner. Steiner behind the baseline to Halzer. Halzer loses the handle, but she's going to be fouled going to the basket by Team Stasiak. And it'll be out of bounds to the Academy with 23 seconds to play in the first quarter.
It's the first foul.
Grace Halzer will trigger it in. Baseline left for the Lady Eagles. Rochester up by two in the closing seconds. Three for Chris Lieb is no good. Malco with the board. Malco leads ahead to Stasiak. Stasiak, right-handed layup on the way. No foul. Gets the rebound back. The putback, no good. B-Pollock's putback is no good. And Carter with the rebound. 8 seconds. Halzer ahead to Chris Lieb. Stolen by Murphy with six. Murphy and Hassel with four. Ahead to B-Pollock with three. Left-handed layup on the buzzer is no good. Rochester leads 14-12. You're listening to Lady
Zebra
Basketball, 92.1
WROI. How's the water in your home? You're still doing things the hard way with hard water? Scrubbing soap scum and scale off everything? Plus all that extra soap and moisturizer for your dry skin. And let's not forget the spotty dishes and scratchy dull laundry. What a mess. Take it from me. Save yourself a lot of trouble and money by having your Culligan man test your water. Right now you can try a Culligan softening or drinking water system for only $20 a month. Call 574-223-2420. That's 574-223-2420. Or go to CulliganFultonCounty.com. Just say, hey, Culligan man. Culligan, better water, pure and simple. See dealer for details.
Local people making a big difference when it comes to insurance needs. Insurance does not have to be complicated. That's why Smith, Sawyer, and Smith Insurance are your local trusted choice agent. They have access to multiple insurance carriers that offer competitive pricing and individual coverage. Call 574-223-2166 or stop by their downtown location at 124 East 8th Street, Rochester, or visit their website at www.smithsawyerins.com. Smith Sawyer Smith Insurance, protecting individuals and families since 1932.
Zebra Basketball, WROI. Second quarter we go here at Rochester High School. The Lady Zebras winning 14-12 at this point. And after the quarter break, as we start the second, Rochester will get the basketball. point blank misses right now the difference in this game.
Yeah, a couple by Stasiak and Pollock. It's easy layups there. They got to have those.
Murphy to paint, though. Luke Patton to the Pollock. Not only made the shot from 2 feet in, but she drew a foul on Victoria Christie.
Okay, all number two is Victoria Christie.
Team 8, Chris Lee and Stiers and Weinberg, three starters for the Lady Eagles.
I've heard this song before.
Yeah.
Like last Tuesday night. Pollock's free throw on the way is good. She completes a three-point play and pushes Liz into the biggest lead of the night for Rochester of 5 at 17-12.
Let's hope the percentages are a little better than Tuesday.
Yeah, you're right. So the Academy has it, giving to cutting Chris Lee, but she's holding her back as she comes out of there gimpy, and the ball's in the backcourt. It's going to be an over and back against the Academy, and it'll be Rochester basketball right in front of the Culver Academy bench with 7:38 to play in the first half, up by five. Nope, it's going to be out of bounds underneath our basket.
Eagles. Eagles.
Brad Thomas, I'm David Musselman. High school girls basketball tonight on WROI. Rochester hosting the Academy and leading 17-12. Malco on the right side. Becky, couple of dribbles, out top to Murphy between the ring. Works left side against McGinnis. Picks up a dribble, feeds down low to P. Pollock, first shot in the paint, is good! Pushes the lead to 7.
Pollock with 9 already in the
goal. Really?
Yes.
Chris Lee, high on the right side. I didn't realize that.
He's got all 5 here in the last 2 minutes.
McGinnis' pass is knocked out of bounds by Malco. He'll stay with the Academy right in front of the Rochester bench. With 7:10 to play in the first half. Again, Rochester up 19-12. And back into the game will come Stiers for the Lady Eagles, and she'll replace
McGinnis. Return to the Eagle number 24, Tori Stiers.
So Holzer will look to trigger it in for the Lady Eagles. Rochester up by 7 with 7:10 to play in the first half. In the corner to
Christie Pokes and Pollock down low
against the zone. Tries to force it in, and Rochester grabs the air pass. Another turnover on the Lady Eagles.
Got 8. Nine.
Yep. Murphy works high on the right side, looking down low to Pollock. Gets her against the triple team. Cross-court pass to Beck. X, the baby hook in the lane is on the way, no good, and Chris Lee with the rebound. Chris Lee, baseball pass ahead to Steiner. Steiner hesitates, travels, goes to the basket, and there it is.
Tenth turnover. I think Coach Stasiak wanted to see Pollock take that ball up off the glass.
Well, knowing that you got
Chris Lee guarding her,
yep. You're right.
Regardless of the triple team.
So, the Academy will win a full court press. Rochester up 19-12. Pass goes into Murphy, back to Malco. Becky. With Steiner on her hip, brings it up the floor, and she's finally a foul is called against Steiner. And that's going to set Becky Malco in line for one of the bonus with 6:35 to play in the first half. Rochester up 19-12. At Pioneer, Winamac now leads 14-0 in the Class 1A regional. First one by Malco's in and out, no good. Chris Lee with the board. Victoria Christie will bring it up herself high on the left side, and she checks it in. Well, the Coach Reinhold is standing in the locker room doors, and it's going to go back to Rochester after another Lady Academy turnover, Academy Lady Eagle turnover.
So the turnovers and the fouls not helping them.
Yeah, you're right.
Lady Zebra speed causing them a little difficulty.
Holland works right wing. Now between the rings, she tries to force a pass in to Malco, stolen by Etheridge, and then she throws it behind the cutting player Stiers out of bounds. Rochester will get it back after the 12th turnover.
Yeah, make a good play on defense,
yeah,
and then throw it away at the other end of the floor.
6:10 to play. First half, Rochester by 7, 19-12. Murphy works right side. Lob pass down low to Pollock. Pollock with Chris Liebener on her hip. Throws it out of bounds with no touch.
Huh.
Okay.
That's, either you're fouled or you threw it up, got knocked out. You don't typically just throw it against the wall.
Not usually.
No.
So the Academy has it now going to all right. And the pass goes into the middle, tipped away, but Rochester picked up by Pollock, and Rochester runs the other way up by 7. Murphy, middle of the floor, out of control a little bit in the paint, feeds down to Pollock, her jumper's good. Double figures, first of the year. Left side is Stiers. Stiers against the 1-3-1 zone of the Lady Zebras. Now high left side to Etheridge, back to Stiers between the rings. 21-12 Rochester with 5:20 to play in the first half. Steiner, right corner to Holzer. Holzer top of the key to Chris Lee. Her three is off the mark again. Rolls nothing but backboard. And Dee Pollock picks up the board.
I understand she's got the green light out there, but none of her shots have looked good from that distance.
I agree.
She needs to keep working down low. That's where she was hurting us.
5 minutes to play, first half. Rochester by nine. The pick and roll down to Pollock, and she travels. Back in the game is Weinberg. Coming out is Victoria Chrisleeve.
I wouldn't be surprised if Weinberg doesn't provide a spark here for this Lady Eagles. She's got that potential.
Steiner runs the point. Dyers now high on the left side for the Lady Eagles. One dribble picks it up. Now Etheridge top of the key. Left side to Holzer. Holzer working against the man-to-man defense. Down in the corner. To Dyers. And Dyers' pass is knocked out of bounds by the Lady Zebras. It will stay with the Academy Lady Eagles baseline left. 4.5 to play, first half. Rochester 21 to Culver Academy 12. And Lady Eagles with the basketball. Dyers gives to Weinberg, three in the way, left side, off the mark, no good. Holland shies to the board, stays from going out of bounds. She can't save from going out of bounds, and we'll go back to Culver baseline right.
Still 14-0 at Pioneer High School.
Watching the live broadcast of that, too, by the way. Dyers, jumper just inside the arc, goes.
Culver Academy basket number 34, Academy Eagles.
Well, the entire second quarter.
Good call. 21-14 Rochester with 4:10 to play in the first half. Pass goes to Pollock. B against the double team. Gives to Stasiak. She's fouled on the shot. She'll go to the line to shoot two. Team Stasiak wearing a mouthpiece tonight after being clubbed in the jaw on Tuesday.
Number 23, Chris
Holzer picks up.
At the bottom of the floor, the Zebras, number 12, Stasiak.
Stasiak line for two freebies for her Lady Zebras. Rochester up by seven. First on the way for the sophomore. Bounces off the back of the rim and no good. She'll have one more. One more coming for the sophomore. Looking to push this lead back to eight. Second one is good again. 4 minutes to play. First half, 22-14 Rochester. And the Lady Eagles quickly up the floor going to our right. Lob pass in the corner is knocked out of bounds by Murphy. And it'll stay with Culver Academy baseline right. 22-14, Rochester on top. 4 minutes to play in the first half. Holzer looks to get it in over the defense to Stiers. Left side to Eldridge. Eldridge to Weinberg. She loses the handle, gives to Malco. Malco pushes ahead to Hex. Hex off the glass. Good. With 3:40 to play in the first half. Weinberg has her pass to only Stasiak. 3-on-2 break. Stasiak goes to the basket, high off the backboard. No good. And the rebound fall for her. Weinberg comes out of there with for Culver. Now Stiers. Right side to Steiner. Steiner on the right wing. Now back to Stiers. Between the rings to Eldridge. Eldridge with the basketball. To Weinberg. Back to Etheridge. Drives to the basket. Throws up a five-footer. High off the back of the rim. No good. Murphy pulls down the board for Rochester. 3 minutes to play. First half. Rochester by 10. Coach Stasiak said, hey, let's take some time off the clock here. Murphy bounce pass high on the right side to Holland. Like the Holland just holds and studies. Now defense comes out to her. Gives to Becky Malco. Works right side against the man-to-man defense. Picks up her dribble between the rings. Gives to Pollock at the free throw line. B kicks it out to Holland with 2:45 to play in the first half. Again, Rochester by 10 at 24-14. Holland against Stiers. Works right side. On the wing. Gets a pick from Pollock. And the floater in from the paint is good by Holland.
Good day. We can just throw it up on the front of the rim and it'll bounce in.
Left side is Stiers. She goes to the basket before the shot. Murphy's going to be whistled on the reach in. And it'll be free throws. No, it'll be no shot before the shot.
The Academy Eagles.
First foul, second. on the Lady Zebras. Check in, and Murphy's going to sit down. So the Lady Eagles with the ball out of bounds. They get it in.
Out the front. Yep, Steiner, the teardrop shot, no good. Alexa Garrison in the game for the first time for Rochester. Murph sit. 2:05 to play in the first half. Rochester by 12. Malco around the defense. In the paint, kicks it out to X. Three on the way, left wing. Way off the mark, no good. And the rebound to Holzer. Holzer then has her pass tripped away. She gets it back. And almost has her pocket pick. She picks up a loose ball, gives it to Weinberg. Weinberg behind her pass dribble, or behind her back dribble. Throws an arid pass, and B. Pauly picks it up. Man,
yeah,
the Academy getting away with.
Yeah. Well, the turnovers are killing them, but yeah, they're getting away with a lot of pushes.
A minute 40 to play, first half. Rochester up 26-14. Malco crossover dribble in the paint. Stop. Her pass is kicked away by the defense. It'll stay with Rochester underneath their own basket with 90 seconds to play in the first half. Murph will come back. We'll get a break. 26-14 Rochester here late in the first half. Coming up at halftime, we'll talk to junior varsity coach Randy Wynn about their game tonight. They drop a tough one to the Academy 28-13. Murphy in the paint. Gets away with a travel. Maybe a blocked shot by the Academy. Stasiak put back, no good. The Lady Zebras up by 14 to 28-14. Quickly to Culver Academy. Going to our right. Holzer in the corner to Steyer. Steyer around the freshman defender in Garrison. Throws up a shot. It does not go. And the rebound to Stasiak, who gives off to Malco with a minute to play in the first half. And now Rochester will start to burn some clock here. Malco gets away with the carry, and she loses the basketball right to the hands of the Academy. Etheridge, top of the key to Holzer, now left side to Stiers. Stiers in the left corner, one dribble over the top of the defense to Etheridge. Now to Steiner, who drives the baseline, throws a shot over Garrison. Number 16, 30 seconds to play. Becky Malco runs the point, works against the man-to-man defense, crosses the timeline with 20 seconds. Down the paint, stops, kicks it back outside to Murphy, fakes a three, drives. She loses the basketball, and we're going to have a foul on Murph.
That'll be her second.
I think she was trying to get her hand out of there, but
I think she was too.
Good. Back into the game, and Murphy will sit for the rest of the half, which is 14 seconds.
I was just thinking that the Lady Eagles already look winded, far more winded than what the Lady Zebras do. That might be a problem in the third quarter.
You're right. 14 seconds, now 10. Steiner with 8. Out to Etheridge. Now Holzer with 3. They got Stiers with 3. No good. Offensive rebound by Holzer with 2. Out to Etheridge with 1. Her jumper no good. And that'll do it for half. At halftime, Rochester leads 28-16. You're listening to Lady Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
Take the leap into online bill pay with First Federal Savings Bank. Online bill pay is the easier, faster, and safer way to pay all your bills. Hop into the convenience of paying all your bills from one secure website and gain greater control over both your time and your finances. With First Federal's online bill pay, you get control of being able to change, edit, or stop pending payments. You'll have the convenience.
And we're it's all in the name, and at All About Pets, it really is all about pets. All About Pets downtown Rochester is your locally owned pet store that caters to you and your pet. They work hard to bring the very best in pet supplies to our area. Choose from premium pet foods, pet healthcare supplies, toys and treats, small animal food, pet accessories, fish and aquarium supplies. That's All About Pets, one block north of the courthouse on Main Street in Rochester. Their only business is to enhance the happiness of your pet. And we are
back at Rochester High School, getting ready to go to the third quarter. The Culver Academy Lady Eagles will start with the basketball. I'm Brad Thomas. I'm David Musselman here at Rochester High School. Some football games we're following from around the state, around the area, I should say. Winnemac right now is the break, leading Pioneer 14-0. Of course, coming into this one, and depending on what poll you look at, Winnemac could be the number one team in the state, number two, number three. But they're right up there amongst the best. They're leading Pioneer right now 14-0. And the team they would play in the semi-state would be Tri West, Trace Central, or Adams, South Adams in round 7-0 at one point. Yeah.
And Tipton over Oak Hill 42-0. Tipton scored 5 times on their first 8 possessions.
Yeah, that's fair.
Or 8 snaps. Not
8 snaps?
8 snaps of the football. They scored 5 times.
Did Oak Hill bring their defense?
I don't know.
We're going to have a legal screen as we get going here in the third quarter against the Culver Academy Lady Eagles.
Oh, wow. That comes against Chris Lee. That's her third. I'd
like to thank Val.
Center to the run.
Those updates. Of course, we're watching the Winnemac Pioneer game.
Hey, 5-1.
Yeah, yeah.
For multitasking.
That's right. 28-16, Rochester leads.
As I leave you hanging for about 3 seconds.
1-2 zone here. Is that what you see?
Yeah.
Malco, bounce pass cross court to Holland. Holland, a couple of dribbles. Back cross court to Holland. To Pollock. To a cutting Stasiak. First shot goes. And Rochester up
13-15.
Pushed up the floor is Steiner. High on the right side to Stiers. Rochester in a 1-3-1 zone. Gives to Chris Leave at the free throw line. Out to Halzer. She'll fire a 3. No good. Draws nothing but backboard. Stasiak with the board. And bounce pass to Malco, and she'll bring it up the floor. Keaton has a ramp on her right arm now, just below the elbow. Apparently she was dinged up in that first hit, the first half. Murphy drives the right baseline. Goes up for the shot. Her shot. Steiner with senior. Rochester 16. 32-16, Rochester. Pass goes in the corner to Halzer. She travels. Oh, we got a timeout. I thought she traveled. Timeout, Culver. It will be a 30. You're listening to Lady Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WYI.
Statistics show that 99% of all farms are family-owned. If you're a farmer, you want to make certain that you carry on the family tradition by passing it down to the next generation. Make certain that you protect your heritage by talking to your Pekin Insurance Agency, Jennings Insurance in Rochester and Argus. They'll help you create an estate plan for your farm that will treat all heirs equally, even those who don't farm, and have sufficient funds for income, gifts, and estate taxes. You can do all this and more with the right insurance plan from Jennings Insurance, representing Pekin Insurance. Call 574-224-7777 in Rochester and 574-892-5249 in Argus today about carrying on the family legacy for years to come.
Zebra Basketball, WROI.
6:47 to play, third quarter. Rochester up 32-16. And the Academy with the basketball. Chris Lee thought about a 3. Gives off to Stiers. Stiers drives. Throws up a 10-footer. No good. Murphy grabs the board. And then it's taken away by Stiers. Her putback is good. Murphy had it taken away
by Stiers.
Good job of getting position and getting the rebound. But then when she went to do the baseball pass out front, she had it taken from behind.
Rochester up 32-18. B. Pollock at the free throw line. Now to Holland. Now kicks it out to the timeline to Malco. Malco holds. One dribble. Now to Holland. High on the left side is Malco. Chris Lee comes out of that 1-2-2 zone and meets her at the volleyball line to Holland. Back to Malco. Rochester, Brad, content to run.
Yeah, they've
run
got a clock. They've got the lead. They're in no hurry to press the issue.
Malco in the paint, kicks it out to Murphy, 3 on the way, left side is short, and the ball is hauled down before it goes out of bounds by Chris Lee. Now to Stiers, middle of the floor for the Lady Eagles, hesitates, now works left, runs over, he blocks and calls for a charge.
That's got to be waiting to the paint.
5:40 to play in the third, Rochester up 32-18, and they'll get it back after an offensive foul and a turnover.
Fouls
and Becky Malco will run the point for the Lady Zebras. Will cross the timeline right. And picked up by the man-to-man defense of Stiers. Works to the right wing. Lob pass over the defense to Pollock. Pollock, Hirsch, she fouled the shot. Took her to the line to shoot two. Well, you know, we talked to Coach Wynn at halftime about how Alexa Garrison was not bringing the ball down when the ball went into her. That time, the problem was she shot that overhead. Brought it down to her waist. Left a shorter player with an opportunity to take
right.
it away from her.
You're right. Weinberg picked up the foul on the reach-in.
B's free throws in and out and back in. And what was the free throw percentage at halftime?
2 of 5.
Uh-huh. One more coming for B. Pollock's second one is good again.
She only shot about 53% last on Tuesday.
As did the team.
Yeah.
Lob pass over to head out Weinberg. Now on the baseline against the double team. Her pass is stolen away by Rochester's Stasiak. Keaton has it, now pushes up the floor. Keaton right side of the floor, crosses the timeline, works inside the three-point line. Now takes it out to Malco. 34-18. Malco feeds down to Pollock. Pollock backs away and throws up a shot. It's no good. And Chris Lee with the rebound for the Academy Lady Eagles. Now ahead to Halzer. Halzer's right-handed layup is good. 34-20. The lead is cut to 14. And here comes the man to be impressed by Rochester. Murphy bounce pass to Malco. Malco crosses the timeline left. Bounce pass to Murphy now. Right side to Holland. And throws it out of bounds.
Well, Murphy kind of got in a hurry there, passing it to Holland on the right side, threw it behind her.
4:44 to play in the third, 34-20 Rochester, and the Lady Eagles of Culver Academy, the basketball going to our left. 1-3-1 zone again by Rochester's defense. Dyers, oh boy, carries the basketball, no call. And Halzer now high on the left side. Halzer cross court right to Dyers, high on the right side. Back left side to Steiner. Steiner inside the arc. And her pass is knocked away. Chrisley's pass is knocked away by Rochester, and Paula comes up with a loose ball. Another turnover on the Lady Eagles, and Rochester coming to our right up by 14.
Stasiak doing a good job of getting in the passing lane, knocking that away for Pollock.
Murphy's pull-up jumper over. 16-point lead at 36-20.
Murphy with her fourth points of the quarter.
Well, Chrisley was leaving dangerously. I think she's fouled a couple of times on the floor here. Weinberg's jumper from inside.
22. Since the first quarter.
Malco gets the man-to-man defense. Splits a double team, works right side, and she is fouled by Weinberg.
That's her fourth.
Cheap foul on the block, and it's going to be out of bounds to Rochester baseline right.
With 3:45 to play,
third, up by 14 to 36-20.
And the Kennedy comes back in the game.
Like Grant said, Weinberg will sit with four personal fouls.
I really thought she brought energy to the Lady Eagles.
Yeah, and an outside threat.
They're going to hurt not having her in there.
Murphy is fouled on the shot by Victoria Chrisleeb, and that's going to send Murph to the line to shoot two.
That'll be her third.
Lady Eagle foul, number two, Victoria Chrisleeb.
3:40 to play in the third.
Currently
Murphy going to the line to shoot two for the Lady Eagles. Looking to push this lead back to 16. Murph ready. First one on the way for the seniors. No good. She'll have one more.
She had 14 points against the Lady Indians Tuesday night.
And needed to have a big second quarter for Rochester.
Yeah. She really opened that ball game up in the second quarter.
One more for Murph is short. No good. And now we're going to have a lane violation on Culver. And Murphy's going to have one more free throw. I thought that lane violation is going to be on Stasiak.
It's going to be a foul.
So Murph will have one more opportunity. Sets herself, fires the second one, and it's good this time.
And that's her eighth point of the ball game.
37-22 Rochester. Quickly, Steiner up the floor, going to our left. Here comes a double team. McInnes throws the ball to Stiers. Stiers in the baseline, cut off by Malco. Top of the key to Steiner. She'll fire a three for the Lady Eagles. It's good.
37-25.
Rochester on top, gets the full court press. Stasiak now ahead to Pollock. B. Pollock will go in for the right-handed layup. It's good. Finished by Pollock.
That's the first three-pointer by the Lady Eagles all night.
Is it? Okay. Yeah. 14-point lead. Now that pass is back away by Stasiak. Team Stasiak. Let's go. Away. It's good. 25, 3 minutes to play in the third. Dyers, middle of the floor, picks up a dribble against a double team, gives to Chris Lieb. Cross lane pass to Hollers, the tennis shot goes in. 21-27. Murphy split the double team and is fouled. And when doing so, and after the next foul from here on out, Rochester will shoot free throws.
Wow. McKinnon's first.
Academy foul, number four, Margaret McInnes.
Yeah, quickly the Lady Zebras get other teams turned into that foul situation.
Law pass inbounds to Murphy. Murphy against the double team. Gives the head to Malco. 2:40 to play in the third. Malco new look pass to Stasiak. Off the left side of the backboard.
Point this quarter.
43-27 Rochester. Bounce pass in the corner to Halzer. Halzer gets a double team. And her pass is knocked out of bounds. She tried to force it into Chris Lee, but we'll stay with Lady Eagles baseline right. As Garrison will come back to the game.
Number 40, Alexa Garrison.
Very pleased. Murphy for the Rochester Lady Zebras. Brad Thomas, I'm David Musselman. 2:25 to play in the third. Rochester at 43-27. Halzer will look to trigger it in. Halzer in the corner. Stiers. Stiers forces it down low to Chris Lee. Her shot all the way. No good, but a foul coming on Garrison. And B. Polish slow to get up. So Chris Lee will go to the line to shoot two free throws for Lady Eagles first tonight. Yes? First free throw attempts for the Lady Eagles. Garrison's first, team first. Saray Carpenter will come in after the first free throw by Chris Lee. And she gets to go to hit the front of the rim.
Number 44, Saray
Carpenter, for the first time tonight. Saray is a 5'10 sophomore, and Coach Stasiak will use a 30-second timeout. You're listening to Lady Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
Dean Foods have been supplying dairy products to America's tables since 1925. They're proud to bring you outstanding dairy products that promote a healthy living for you and your family. Everyone needs calcium, and dairy products are the purest way to get your daily requirement. When shopping, load up on the perfect foods. Dairy products from Dean Foods, Rochester. Dean Foods, created by nature, delivered by Dean.
Zebra Basketball.
Play in the third, a Rochester up 43-28, and of course we're watching the Winamac and Pioneer regional football game at Pioneer High School. Right now, Winamac leading 14-0, and Pioneer seriously knocking on the door.
Inside the 10 in the third quarter.
And they just scored their first touchdown.
He's going to be short.
Short on the one.
Okay. Mark him short on the one. That's where they fumbled the last time they were down
Pioneers
there.
Had the ball there before and fumbled in the first half. So they're looking to stick this one in. So Victoria Chris Lee with one more free throw for the Lady Eagles here at Rochester High School. The senior fires a second one. It's good again. 43-29. Full court press by the Academy. Malco bounce pass into Holland. Holland bounce pass to Malco. Rochester run. Middle of the floor is Malco. Rochester now with the numbers. Bounce pass down low to Carpenter. She throws him a shot. No good. Garrison's putback is no good. Ball being tipped for. Malco comes out of there with it. Off her knee. She gets it back somehow. Out of X. Now high on the right side to Malco with 2 minutes to play in the third quarter. Rochester up 43-29. Malco gets the man-to-man defense. Works to the right side inside the arc. Throws him a shot off the window. No good. Rebound fought for. Halzer and the Academy comes out of there with it. Runs. Halzer right side of the floor, gives him the corner to Steiner. She'll fire a three for the Eagles. Good!
Eagle basket, number
32, Steiner. Full court press by Culver. Malco, with a minute and a half to play in the third quarter, gives to Stasiak. Breaks the press, middle of the floor. Pass down low to Garrison, and she's fouled a shot by Halzer, and that's going to send Alexa Garrison to the line to shoot two.
Eagle foul, number 23.
9 seconds to play in the third. Sorry, Brad. Number
40.
Picks up her second.
Number 40.
Rochester up by 11. Garrison. Freshman Garrison will have two from the free throw line. First on the way is good as it falls through. Back into the game.
Returning to the Academy. Number 10
is Halzer.
And Pioneer did score. It's 14-6, and they're going for the extra point.
Okay. Second one by the freshman Garrison is no good, and Chris Lee with a rebound. Chris Lee grabs and runs herself. Down low to a wide open. Rochester's lead at 116-18 has been cut to 10. And now we're going to have a foul coming about, 80 feet away from the basket.
That's Steiner's eighth point of the quarter, and she's got 14 for the ball game.
And she just committed another foul, which is going to send Alexa Holland to the
line.
She's
number
for Rochester with 1:17 to play. Ouch. In the third quarter.
That's her fourth foul.
So Murphy and Pollock back into the game. Carpenter and Garrison will sit.
And
Alexa Holland at the line to shoot one of the bonus with 1:17 to play.
You got to pay them?
Yeah, about. The official book says 5 on Steiner. You've got 4.
I've got 4. Not that I count.
1:17 to play in the third quarter. The officials at the scorer's table, and they're going to call it. They're going to check books. And the officials telling each coach to bring him to the bench and talk to him a little bit. When they get this figured out, it's either going to be four or five on Steiner.
Well, earlier in the game, they called a foul on Steiner, but I only saw the official give two fingers. I never saw him give zero or a foul, because I had it as Chris Leap as well, but then changed it later on, and so I'm guessing the official scorebook never made that change.
Okay, so the official scorebook maybe has Chris Leap with not enough fouls if they gave it to Steiner. Is that what you're saying?
Right.
Okay. Well, still checking the book here at Rochester again. 44-34, Rochester leads here with 1:17 to play in the third. After we get this mess figured out, it will be free throws for Rochester as Alexa Holland will be there for one of the bonus. Again, coming up tomorrow, Coach's Corner.
I'm less than official.
Yeah, you said a mouthful there, brother.
Tell I'm watching a football game. What do I know?
So they got to figure it out. How many? Four?
Yeah. I don't know.
I think we're going to stick with four.
It works for me. So Pioneer got the two-point conversion, so it's 14-8.
How big was that fumble, the two now?
Yeah, exactly.
So we got to figure it out. Four on Steiner. And so Alexa Holland will go to the line to shoot one of the bonus for the Lady Zebras, who are up by 10 with 1:17 to play in the third quarter. John, 30-second timeout. You're listening to Lady Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
Coca-Cola Bottling Company of Plymouth wants you to enjoy your world. And now the basketball, swimming, and wrestling are back. And college and pro football continue. There's plenty to do. So whether it's heading for the gym, holiday open houses, and getting together with friends and family, grab the refreshingly clean taste of Coca-Cola, Diet Coke, Coke Zero, Sprite, and Sprite Zero. Make sure you have plenty of Coca-Cola products on hand, either from the store or the vending machine. Coca-Cola products go great with everything you do. It's the real thing. It's Coca-Cola.
Telephone is your lifeline. Lifeline is a federal benefit that makes monthly telephone service more affordable for eligible low-income households. A subscriber that meets criteria as established by the Indiana Utility Regulatory Commission and lives within the Rochester Telephone Company service area must be a participant in one of the following programs to qualify for the Lifeline benefit: Medicaid, food stamps, supplementary security income, federal public housing assistance, low-income home energy program, temporary assistance to needy families, national school lunch free program, and income-based federal eligibility. Only one Lifeline benefit per household is allowed. For more information or to see if you qualify for Lifeline assistance, please call Rochester Telephone Company at 223-2191.
Your Fulton County REMC is proud to offer the new Faster Exceed Satellite Internet service. They can now connect customers to their fastest satellite internet service ever with broadband speeds up to 12 megabytes per second. For homeowners with fewer options for internet service or who live in rural areas, there's no better option than Exceed Broadband. Share photos remarkably fast. Enjoy better video chat with less jitter. Send and receive files quickly. Exceptionally fast web browsing and email. Listen to streaming music. If you're ready for a faster internet connection, you're ready for Exceed Broadband. Call 574-223-3156 today to learn more about the amazingly fast Exceed broadband service offered by your local Fulton County REMC, your Touchstone Energy provider.
Zebra Basketball, WROI.
Back at Rochester High School, as we're away, the foul situation is taken care of in both books. They and Alexa Holland hits both free throws to put Rochester back up by 12, and the half-court trap turns the ball over. Becky Malco,
in the first quarter,
they took note.
They're paying off now.
Going over and back, the ball Rochester forces another turnover. Great job by the top of that trap, which is Malco X and B. Pollock.
Well, I quit keeping track of the turnovers at 20. So, and they just had two there. So you know they got at least 22 turnovers for the Lady Eagles tonight. That's
right. Well,
never
first
a
game.
It is their first game, yeah. But never a good situation.
55 seconds to play, third quarter. Rochester up by 14. And Holland has it. Bounce pass high on the left side to Murphy. Murphy, a couple of dribbles with 43. Gives off to Alexa Holland, who drives left with 39. Holland, crossover dribble, works back middle to the floor at the volleyball line with 35. Now gives it to Malco with 33. Malco against the man-to-man defense. Bounce pass to Murphy with 30. Murphy works right wing with 25. Picks up a dribble, gives to X with 22. Holland holds, now drives left with 19. Rochester by 14 as the third quarter coming to an end. Malco now with 13. Drives left side in the paint. Dump pass down low to Pollock. Her jumper on the way is short. And rebound fought for. B comes out of there with it with 7. And off the hip to Chris Lieb. Now Malco shields it with 3. Now Murphy at the buzzer. 3 on the way is no good. After 3, Rochester leads 48-34. You're listening to Lady Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
Got credit. Come and get it. Mike Anderson, Chrysler Dodge Jeep Ram of Rochester, has your back when it comes to financing a car. We finance almost everyone. Credit challenged? Come and get it. Bad credit or no credit? Come and get it. Why are we so sure we can finance you? Mike Anderson owns the finance company. There's no middleman. Let Mike Anderson give you the fresh start you deserve today. And right now, during the Big Finish 2013, is your best chance. Choose from hundreds of new and certified pre-owned cars at Mike Anderson Chrysler Dodge Jeep Ram, all prepared to sell out. Like a new 2014 Dodge Dart SE for only $19,303. Mike Anderson Chrysler Dodge Jeep Ram is waiting to finance your next car at 1702 Main Street in Rochester or at MikeAnderson.com. Remember, we've got credit. Come and get it at Mike Anderson Chrysler Dodge Jeep Ram. To qualified buyers with approved credit, see dealer for details.
Zebra Basketball, WROI.
Fourth and final quarter here at Rochester High School. The Lady Zebras leading by 14 at 48-34, and Rochester will start the fourth and final quarter with a basketball. Brad Thomas, I'm David Musselman. The original five still on the floor for the Rochester Lady Zebras.
Fourth quarter. The Murphy, the
fourth
quarter.
Two fouls.
Okay.
So Rochester will start with the basketball, up by 14. Malcolm will look to get it in. Just so to Murphy. Murphy across the timeline. Here comes a little bit of, well, man-to-man defense. I thought they were going to set up into a trap.
It's dangerous for Chrisley.
Ball loose. Going to be tied up, and Rochester will get a point. Very lucky. Coming over the back of
Pollock, working against her pretty hard down low. Chrisley with four fouls. I'm sorry, three. Three fouls.
Are you sure?
No, Rob, better check.
Chris Lieb gets the inbound pass from Stiers. Gets it back to Stiers, middle of the floor, down low to a wide-open McKinnis. She puts the ball up. It's no good. Rebound to Stasiak. Keaton, then bounce pass to Malco. Becky Malco splits the double team. Oh, can't throw behind him. She tries to throw about throwing it behind the timeline, but instead throws over the head of B. Pollock and out of bounds. It'll go back to Culver. Rochester up by 14, 7.5 to play in the game. I'm telling you. Rob Malco sitting on the bench, and Becky throws it out of bounds. He handles it better than I would. Ball loose on the floor, picked up by McKinnis. She goes up for the shot. It's off the back of the rim, no good. Ball fought for. X comes out of the whiff. We're going to have a tie-up. Rochester going to get it back.
I don't think that's the gum in his mouth. I think that's what's left of this program.
7:14 to play in the game. Rochester at 48-34. And Rochester will be looking at a full-court press as they try to inbound underneath the Academy basket. Malco lobs it into Murphy. Misses a streaking Pollock, and then Murphy throws the basketball away.
So what do you say? You're not going to do this next year?
Right.
Well, really?
Yeah.
I can't see that either.
7 minutes of play in the ball game. Rochester by 14, and Culver turns it over again. And now Malco quickly up the right side of the floor. Becky, right side, has her pass tipped away. Ball loose, and Chris Lee picks it up. Now quickly to Stiers. Stiers on the left side, high on the left side. Stiers now fills the middle of the floor. Works right side to Cortez. Bounce pass to Stiers at the elbow. Stiers drives around Murphy, throws up a shot. She's fouled on the shot. She'll go to the lane for two.
Murph's going to pick up her third foul. So we're giving John a year's notice to
give him 5 seconds
away.
Actually, you know, yeah, that's exactly. I stay here.
Number 24.
Yeah.
Doris Sire.
first one for Stiers is no good off the back of the iron. So one more.
At
least you're locked in behind the table.
6:42 to play. Stiers with one more for the Lady Eagles. 14-point lead right now for Rochester at 48-34. Second one's no good again. Stasiak, a good block out, grabs the board and gives to Murphy. 6:35 to play in the game. Rochester by 14. Here comes a little half-court trap. Nope, it's a man-to-man defense. Murphy all the way in the paint, throws up a shot, it goes!
Number 54,
point of the night.
Quickly up before the Lady Eagles. Stiers, outside left to Steiner. Steiner bounce pass to Chris Lee. Drives the left baseline, and Murphy going to pick up a foul.
Wow.
Legal foul, Charlie Murphy. At the line, four.
And Alexa Garrison comes back in. And Murphy picked up foul number three.
All right, Alexa Garrison.
They called the other foul on the...
to play in the game. Rochester by 16. Chris Lee gets the inbounds pass. Pull-up jumper at the free throw line. No good, short. Rebound fall four off the head of Garrison and out of bounds. It'll stay with Culver baseline right.
Stay low, keep them in front.
So Winnemack has just scored on Pioneer.
Halzer is it in to Stiers. Stiers, the elbow, pull-up jumper. No good. Stasiak, another board. Now Keaton clears to Malco. Stasiak begging for a foul on Chris Lieb. That'll go now, backs it out. We'll set up the offense. Works the middle of the floor. Switches directions. Down at the free throw line. Bounce pass outside behind the arc to X. Back to Malco between the rings. Malco in the paint. Stops. Cut off by the defense. To Stasiak on the right wing. Keaton drives the baseline. In the paint now. Leaner on the way, off the window. Good. Half-court trap coming for Rochester. Now Coach Stasiak calls it off. In the corner to Steiner. Dump pass down low to Weinberg and throws it right to the hands of Malco, who almost was tripped by Chris Lieb. Goes coast to coast on the block. Throws it off the hands of Culver and out of bounds. It'll stay with Rochester.
So, once again, the Lady Zebras with three in double digits tonight. Stasiak with nine, so she's on the precipice of being the fourth.
Rochester will take a 60-second timeout. You're listening to Lady Zebra Basketball, 92.1.
The next time you buy a cart full of groceries, make a car payment, or write that big mortgage check, ask yourself, what would my family do if I wasn't there to buy those groceries, or make that car payment, or write that check? If you didn't like the answer, ask a State Farm agent about life insurance and start getting some answers you will like. Welcome to that place where doing it for them meets doing it today. Get started by contacting State Farm agent Jeff Klinkhammer at 223-3017.
Is your water softener on the job protecting you from higher energy bills, dingy laundry, and spotted dishes? A water softener can save you as much as 20% of your energy bill, but only if your water softener has been set properly for hardness and your water use. Water stores and home improvement stores don't size properly because they don't have enough choices. For more choices, home salt delivery to any brand softener and a 30-day satisfaction guarantee, call Culligan of Fulton County, 574-223-2420. Culligan, better water, pure and simple.
Zebra Basketball, WROI.
5:09 to play the game. Rochester up by 18 at 52-34. And Keaton Stasiak having a fantastic day on the floor.
Yeah, 9 points, 10 rebounds, so just almost a double-double.
Late in the third quarter at Pioneer, Winnemack leading the Panthers in the regional championship 21-8. And right now, Rochester cruising here at Rochester High School by the count of 52-34.
Rensselaer leading Bremen 14-0 at the halftime.
And, of course, Rensselaer will have a Tipton next week in the semi-state. Rensselaer already beat Tipton once this year.
Oh, wow.
They're in the same conference. Figure that one.
Yeah, Tipton not having any trouble with Oak Hill.
Stasiak in the paint. Leaner on the way. Off the glass. No good. B. Pollock with the rebound. Her put back over. Chris Lieb is good.
Pollock
with
17.
In the corner to Halzer. To Stiers, who is on the cut. Gives out to Chris Lieb. Left side to Weinberg. At the free throw line to Steiner. Outside to Halzer. Long three. No good. Pollock with another board. B, trying to get away from the defense, who has her hands all over her. Gives to Malco. Becky. Down low to Garrison. Garrison back to Malco. Her shot partially blocked by Chris Lee. Gets a rebound back. Put back is no good. A ball being tipped around. And Culver comes out of there with it. The Academy runs to our left. And Steyer gives to cutting Chris Lee. Jumper at the free throw line. No good. Garrison to the board. Nice job of the freshman. And clears to Stasiak, who gives to X.
The Lady Eagles have not scored a point in this quarter.
Malco kicks it out to Holland with 4 minutes to play in the game. Rochester by 20. And Malco around the defense. Loses the basketball. Ball loose in the paint. It's going to be tied up. It's going to go to
the Bachelor. Over again.
So Chris Lee will trigger it in. Quickly. The ball tipped away by Garrison, and she picks it up and loses it out of bounds. Boy, she has some pressure in her face by Halzer from
Halzer.
Couldn't get through the defense.
Garrison comes out. Nice minutes given there for the Lady Zebras, and Murphy back in. 3:47 to play in the game. Rochester up 54-34, and Halzer will look to trigger it in baseline right underneath her own basket. Bounce pass in to Stiers. Her three no good. The putback by Steiner's no good, but a foul coming, I believe, on Keaton Stasiak. And that's going to send Steiner to the line to shoot two for her Lady Eagles.
Stasiak
third.
Stasiak at the line shooting two for the Academy, number 20, Marie Steiner.
Steiner's first free throw is good as it hits the side of the rim, rolls around, hits the backboard and falls through. She'll have one more.
The first point in the quarter for the Lady Eagles.
Lock out, lock out, lock out.
Marie Steiner, the 5'9 sophomore, will have one more. Second one is short. Rebound to Pollock.
Don't leave her.
B, with Chris leaving her face, has the ball loose. Picked up by Weinberg, and she goes to the Rochester end and stops right close to the timeline. Now gives the Steiner. She throws the shot up. It's good. There should be, as Chris leaves through Stasiak to the floor hard.
Finally.
And that's going to be a foul on Chris Lee, number four. And coming
number
back
four,
into the game is McGinnis. And he's able to walk together at the floor and won the bonus.
So the basket by Steiner?
The basket by Steiner is good.
A two or a three?
A two.
Okay.
So Stasiak with one of the bonus. Well, she's had two games, and she has gotten beat up both games. And this is not over yet. Three and a half to play in the game. 54-37.
Stasiak.
Rochester on top. Stasiak with one of the bonus for the Lady Zebras. First one for the sophomore, short, and the rebound to McKinnis. To Steiner, dumps down low to Chris Lee, kicks out to McKinnis. Here comes the double team, out to Steiner, top to Stiers. Stiers, a couple of dribbles, 3:15 to play in the game. Left side to Chris Lee, cross court to Steiner on the baseline. Steiner, McKinnis, almost has a stolen. Stiers has it, throws up a shot in the lane. It's no good. Pollock with another board and gives to Murphy. Murphy, bounce pass to Malco. Coach Stasiak says, hey, let's run. Loses the handle. Chris Lee picks it up. Chris Lee loses the handle, and we're going to have a double dribble on Chris Lee. It's going to go back to Rochester. 3:54 to play in the game, 54-37. Rochester on top, full court press by the Lady Eagles as Murphy will look to get it in. Bounce pass into Holland. Alexa takes the pass, drives, hesitates, drives again, now walks it through the center circle. Works to the left side, crossover dribble, now right side. Bounce pass to Malco, off her knees, ball's loose. Turnover again, picked up by McKinnis. McKinnis loses the basketball out of bounds and back to Rochester. 2:36 to play in the game. Rochester up 54-37. And Rochester basketball after another turnover by the Academy, which is around 25 or 26.
I got him for 25.
And Stiers has just picked up a foul, and that's going to send Rochester to the line to shoot two from here on out.
I got 12 on the Lady Zebras.
No.
Academy foul.
That's
going to
be
a 18.
That's what Randall has.
Stiers.
Oh.
so he's right.
So either he says none or 20.
All righty.
Malco's first one's good for the Lady Zebras. One more coming. Calls her back. 2:32 to play in the game. Rochester up 55-37. One more free throw coming for Malco, looking to push us back to a 19-point lead. Second one is no good, and Chris Lee with the board. She rips and runs. Chris Lee bounce past to Steiner. Back to Chris Lee in the paint. Jumper on the way. No good. Ball tipped around. Malco comes out of there with it. Gives to Murphy. Murph now to Holland. X. Bounce pass ahead to Malco. Malco is then fouled by Etheridge, and that's going to send Becky Malco back to the line for two shots.
Etheridge picks up her second.
Number 10, Jesse Etheridge.
And Coach stays back with the bench. As Hannah Odell will come in for the first time after the first free throw by Malco. Rochester up by 18. First one by the sophomore is no good off the side of the range. One more. So Sierra Carpenter, Lexi Garrison, back into the game. Murph steps down, B. Parker steps down. And Odell apparently going to play with Malco in the free throw. 2:16 to play in the game. Chris Lee has done as well for the Lady Eagles. 55-37. Second one by the sophomore is no good again. And the rebound to Culver.
Holland
around the defense. Cross the timeline. We'll run some clock. 2:05 to play in the game. And Coach Stasiak calls for the three-man weave. Dribbles to the elbow, does Holland. Now back to behind the three-point line. Picks up a dribble, bounce pass to Malco with a minute 50 to play in the game. Malco now near the timeline, middle of the floor. Bounce pass to X near the near side of the minute 45. X dribbles a couple of times to her left. Now in the middle of the floor. Drives left side to Stasiak. Stasiak one dribble, bow back to Holland with a minute 40 to play. 55-37, Rochester on their way to a 2-0 start. And we're going to have a 5-second call against Rochester. We're going to give it back to the Academy. And Odell comes into the game for the first time. Odell is a 5'8 freshman for the Lady Zebras, and Malco will sit. She is done. 90 seconds to play in the game. Holzer behind the arc left side. Rochester by 18. Holzer directs traffic. Gives to Steiner. Three on the way. Right wing is short. And the rebound of the Culver Academy Lady Eagles. Back to Steiner. Now to Holzer. Holzer against Stasiak. Gives to Etheridge. Her three on the way. No good. And Holland with the rebound. And runs right with 68 seconds to play in the game. Now fills the middle of the floor. We'll run some clock with 60 seconds to go. Rochester by 18. Left side of the floor, in the paint, floored on the way off the glass, is good.
Number 10,
now by 20. Not sure how that went, but it did go in.
Holland now with 13. That's four of the Lady Zebra starters.
Double digits. Good for them. That shot no good. Carpenter fights for the rebound and grabs it. And gives it off now to Stasiak with 35. Rochester by 20. And we're closing in the final seconds of the game, and Coach Stasiak will call a 30-second timeout to get some other kids in.
Stasiak with her double-double tonight.
Kendall Davis comes in, a sophomore at 5'5 freshman in the game tonight for Rochester, and all the starters are done. 32.8 to play in the game. Rochester by 20. And Coach Chris Lee tried to clear his bench as well. Didn't do it. Hannah Odell has it now outside left. Odell picks up her dribble. And got to get rid of it. Bounce pass to Hyatt. And then we're going to have a tie-up in Rochester. 22.7 to play in the game.
Checking in with the Academy, number 42, Lauren Reed.
Lauren Reed comes in for the first time for the Academy. A 5'10", a 5'3", sophomore, that is. And the inbounds pass goes into Hyatt, stolen by the Academy with 20. 20-point lead for Rochester. Nice wraparound pass to Cortez, who jumper goes with 12. Hyatt gets it into Odell with 10. 57-39 Rochester. Hyatt loses the handle. Ball loose with 5. Ball still loose. Going to have a tie-up. The Academy going to get it. 5 seconds to go in the game. Rochester up 57-39. Again, Rochester going to be 2-0 after this one. And we'll take on the Cast and Lady Comets on the 19th next week. We'll be at that game as well. Reed has her shot blocked by Garrison. Picked it up with 2, with 1, and that'll do it. at the buzzer. The shot goes for the
Chris Lee and his Lady Eagles, the very best in the return of the Philadelphia fans.